In this video, we are going to see about classification of organisms. Characterization, classification, and identification are major objectives in all branches of the biological sciences. Classification is a means of bringing order to the bewildering variety of organisms in nature. Once we learn the characteristics of an organism, we can compare it with other organisms to discover similarities and differences. So, we can arrange similar things together in groups and to distinguish these groups from one another. Two kingdom system. One of the earliest systems of classification called the two kingdom classification was proposed by Carolus Linnaeus, a Swedish botanist. He classified all living organisms into two kingdoms on the basis of nutrition and locomotion. His books on the classification of plants and animals are considered to be the beginning of modern botanical and zoological nomenclature, a system of naming plants and animals. Nomenclature in microbiology, which came much later, was based on the principles established for the plant and animal kingdoms. Until the 18th century, the classification of living organisms placed all organisms into one of two kingdoms, plant and animal. In microbiology, we study some organisms that are predominantly plant-like, others that are animal-like, and some that share characteristics common to both plants and animals. Since there are organisms that do not fall naturally into either the plant or the animal kingdom, it was proposed that new kingdoms be established to include those organisms which typically are neither plants nor animals. Three kingdom system. In 1866, E. H. Eckel, a German zoologist, suggested that a third kingdom, Protista, be formed to include those unicellular microorganisms that are typically neither plants nor animals. These organisms, the protists, include bacteria, algae, fungi, and protozoa. Bacteria are referred to as lower protists. The others, algae, fungi, and protozoa, are called higher protists. Next, we are going to see about the important discovery, that is, discovery of presence and absence of membrane-bound internal structures in protists. When more definitive observation of internal cell structure was made possible with the aid of the powerful magnification provided by electron microscopy, it was discovered that in some cells, for example, in typical bacteria, a nuclear substance was not enclosed by a nuclear membrane. In other cells, such as typical algae and fungi, the nucleus was enclosed in a membrane. This discovery, the absence of membrane-bound internal structures in one group of protists, that is, in bacteria, and the presence of membrane-bound internal structures in all others, that is, in algae, fungi, and protozoa, was a discovery of fundamental significance. Further research has revealed additional differences in the internal structure of these cells. These two cell types have been designated prokaryotic and eukaryotic. Organisms of each cell type are called prokaryotes and eukaryotes respectively. Bacteria are prokaryotic microorganisms. The eukaryotic microorganisms include the protozoa, fungi, and algae. Plants and animal cells are also eukaryotic. We should note one important thing here, that is, viruses are left out of this scheme of classification. We take a five kingdom concept. The five kingdom classification was proposed by R. H. Whittaker. This system of classification is based on three level of cellular organization, which evolved to accommodate three principal modes of nutrition: photosynthesis, absorption, and ingestion. The prokaryotes are included in the kingdom Monera. They lack the ingestive mode of nutrition. Unicellular eukaryotic microorganisms are placed in the kingdom Protista. The multicellular and multinucleate eukaryotic organisms are found in the kingdoms Plantae, Animalia, and Fungi. Their diversified nutritional modes leads to a more diversified cellular organization. Microorganisms are found in three of the five kingdoms, that is, in Monera, Protista, and Fungi. According to Whittaker's five kingdom concept, bacteria and cyanobacteria are included in kingdom Monera. All single-celled eukaryotes, that is, microalgae and protozoa, are included in kingdom Protista. Heterotrophic, eukaryotic, multinucleate, multicellular, and unicellular fungi. For example, molds, mushroom, puffballs, yeast, etc. are included in kingdom Fungi. Multicellular green plants and higher algae are included in kingdom Plantae. Multicellular animals are included in kingdom Animalia. Friends, before concluding, I want to ask you one question. That is, I told you that kingdom Protista includes all single-celled eukaryotes. My question is that, why yeast is included in kingdom Fungi and not in kingdom Protista? With the hope that you will be answering my question, I'm concluding my video here. See you soon in my next video. Thank you, friends.